I'm sorry, little buddy.
Not that little.
I'm gonna do better. I'm sorry, I've neglected you. Gentlemen, if you don't care about your package, this video isn't for you. And if the topic of Big Al and the boys makes you feel uncomfortable, this video also isn't gonna be for you. Before you go, drop me one of these to be like, yo, Alpha, my boys, they're straight. But for the rest of you who aren't afraid to tackle the topic of testicles, say that 5 times fast. Today, we're going over 5 underwear mistakes that are damaging your package. And make sure to stick around for the end of the video, because after I go over the 5 things that are damaging it, I'm going to go over some underwear tricks to make it look big. Whoever said all men were created equal apparently didn't watch porn. Some men were born a little bit more mas grande, while others of us more modest. And depending on you and your package, certain underwear are going to be better for you. Others are actually going to be worse and damage what you got going on down there. And so the first thing we got to talk about in terms of a very common underwear mistake is wearing underwear that are too tight. So I'm not even talking about the style right now. I'm just talking about in general. All right, if you are wearing underwear that keep everything like super high, super tight, and super constricted, this is actually reducing your sperm count. So I'm going to explain this kind of like you're 3 years old. Sometimes our junk is up like super high. Other times it's a little bit lower. The reason is because our testicles are super freaking smart and they're trying to preserve the integrity of our sperm. So I'm giving the testicles credit, but technically it's our scrotum, right? That's the real brains behind the operation. Your scrotum's job and only job is to make sure that your testicles stay at a specific temperature because they don't want to damage your sperm. And you're cold, boom, right up to the body and you're like, damn, oh my god, what's happening here? Your scrotum is like, yo, I'm gonna put these testicles up close to your body in order to keep the sperm a little warmer. If you're hot or you have a fever, your scrotum's like, yo, I gotta get these things away from your hot ass body. So boom! If you are wearing underwear that are too tight and too constricting on your junk, it prevents your scrotum from doing what it does, which is be a genius. The other problem with wearing underwear that are too tight actually brings us to the second big underwear mistake, which is wearing sweaty underwear. It's like a man meat sauna down your pants, right? Because think about it. You got Big Al and the twins. You've also got your thighs. You've got your body. Everything is jammed together and you're warm and you're walking and you're rocking and rolling, chasing spicy senoritas. Everything's all like bunched up and like constricted. So what are you gonna do? You gonna wear boxers and just let everything all like go crazy? You gonna go commando? No and no. Gentlemen, boxers, in my opinion, are one of the absolute worst underwear styles out there. The reason is because all that extra fabric gets all crazy and bunched up and it offers no support. Commando? Terrible, which is actually the third underwear mistake, not wearing any underwear. Hey, show of hands, who's accidentally like nipped their wiener when zipping up their pants going commando? Exactly, I think we all have. The other problem with not wearing underwear, there is zero support. The other problem is that when you don't have any fabric absorbing the sweat, absorbing the odor, your jeans end up smelling like your balls. In terms of solving the first 3 problems, guys, there is a new underwear technology that I want to tell you about today. It's from today's video sponsor, Sheath. The way that Sheath works, it actually has a built-in pouch inside of the underwear. So the founder, Robert, started Sheath to solve a problem that he was facing. He was a soldier, right? He was overseas, he was in the desert, and he was walking around, and he was getting incredibly chafed because of everything rubbing, and he's like, yo, what am I gonna do? And he realized, hey, wait a second, if I'm not all like man-meat sausage packed in my pants, and things were a little more separated, I'd be cooler. He's desperate to try and create some type of separation from Big Al and the twins and his body. And so he started like experimenting, cutting up socks and doing all sorts of things. And as a result, Sheath underwear was born. Now, when I first heard about Sheath, I was like, what, a pouch? And how does it work? So from the outside, when you're wearing them, Sheath just look like super sexy, badass boxer briefs, right? The fabric, ridiculous. But on the inside, this is where the magic happens, all right? As you can see, there's a little pouch. That pouch, you actually place your scrotum in there. And then see that little hole, right? There's another chamber up front. You stick your penis through the hole. So essentially, Sheath has 3 separate compartments in order to keep everything separated. The result is that you stay dry. It also makes your junk look amazingly big. I don't know if that was like planned that way. I doubt it. But the fact is that when I wear my Sheath, everything like just looks gigantic because everything is separated. Now, here's the thing. You're probably thinking like I was. You're like, yo, is it comfortable? More. Sheath underwear underwear are more comfortable than any other underwear I've ever worn. If you've got testicles, you gotta hit that link down below and go check out Sheath. There's also a discount code. Guys, here's the deal. They've got a ton of different styles. Bottom line, if you are ready to stop having like super sweaty balls and chafing and your balls sticking to your leg, gentlemen, it is time to hit that link and use the discount code Alpha. You're gonna get 20% off your order. I'm telling you guys, once you try Sheath, you will never rock another pair of underwear again because they are amazing. The other amazing thing about rocking Sheath underwear is that you don't smell as bad. No more musky nuts. And the reason is because everything's separated. It's when everything is all jam-packed together, things get hot, you sweat more. More sweat, it's dark, the odor, bacteria, but with Sheath, Fourth, underwear mistake that is damaging your junk is actually wearing underwear that are too short if you don't have the right body for it. And what I mean by this, if you're wearing briefs or if you're wearing like boxer like trunks that are super short and you've got larger thighs, a lot of times you're gonna get some chafing, and the chafing and the rubbing, the constant irritation, can actually cause like infection. Not to mention it's super freaking uncomfortable. I suffer from chafing. The constant rubbing or friction when you're walking, if you don't have anything protecting your thighs, is damaging. Now, something that I used to try was actually powdering on the inside of my thighs, and honestly this worked a little bit. It didn't work great. What I realized is that if you wear underwear that are a little bit longer in the leg, this is actually going to solve the problem. And last but certainly not least, the fifth underwear mistake that is bad for your boys is actually wearing underwear to bed. Give your boys a little time to breathe and do what they do, right? Which is just kind of chill out and hang out and be amazing and geniuses. Gentlemen, now what I would like to do is actually go over a few underwear tips in order to make it look a little bit bigger. So in terms of being gifted with a gigantic sausage, I was not. But there are some things that I've learned over the years that make it look bigger. Starting with number one, wearing light colored underwear. Lighter colored underwear like whites and light grays make it look gigantic. And the reason, it kind of makes sense. You know how we talk about dark colors being slimming and making everything look small? Light underwear, boom, bounce the light back, making everything appear bigger. Something else I want to tell you that will definitely make it look bigger is wearing shorter underwear. Briefs, boxer briefs, short little trunk underwear also make it look larger. It's all about proportion. And the third trick is what I call the tuck and lift. It's an old model trick, right? You ever see underwear models and think to yourself, my God, man, they're hung like a donkey. The reality is that they know a simple trick. Take your wiener, tuck it straight down, right? And then get your hand and grab everything together and just lift it kind of like up and like out. And you're gonna be amazed at how much like bigger it just like looks, right? Check yourself out in the mirror. It's amazing. It's pretty incredible. And definitely works. If you're worried about that kind of stuff, I'm not. I'm just letting you know what I have found out through a bunch of research because I was interested. Knowledge for you, gentlemen. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you dug this video, make sure to give me one of these to be like, yo, Alpha, thanks for hooking up. Big Al and the twins.